हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर शशिकांत नामकाने, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग ऑफ एन बी नवले सिंहगढ़ कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, केगांव सोलापुर। आई एम हैविंग 11 ईयर्स ऑफ टीचिंग एक्सपीरियंस एंड 1.5 ईयर्स ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल एक्सपीरियंस। आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड माई पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन विथ मैकेनिकल डिजाइन इंजीनियरिंग। सो इन प्रीवियस वीडियो we focused on the balancing of rotating masses. Now in this video I am going to focus on introduction to balancing of reciprocating masses. So for this, consider a horizontal reciprocating engine mechanism as shown in figure. So this is a reciprocating engine mechanism in which OC is the crank which is having angular velocity omega, okay, which is rotated in clockwise direction. Then there is a connecting rod CP which is having length L, and the crank is having length r, small r. Then next element is connecting rod, okay. Then this connecting rod is having connection with piston, so p is the piston which is going to reciprocate in the guides. So when your crank is going to rotate, then the piston is going to reciprocate, okay. So this case is considered for the balancing of reciprocating masses as the piston is going to reciprocate in this case. Now, so the resultant of all forces acting on body of engine due to inertia force only is known as unbalanced force or shaking force. The inertia force developed by all parts of the engine, and that inertia forces are acting on the body of engine, that forces are nothing but the unbalanced force or shaking force. Thus, if resultant of all the forces due to inertia effects is zero, then there will be no unbalanced force. But even then, an unbalanced couple or shaking couple will be present. Okay, so in case of reciprocating masses, there are two unbalanced factor. So first is unbalanced force which is generated due to inertia force or inertia of every part, okay. This is the first thing, and second thing is unbalanced couple or shaking couple. So these two factors are going to generate the vibration in the engine. So balancing of reciprocating masses is nothing but minimizing the effect of unbalanced forces or inertia forces and unbalanced couple or shaking couple is nothing but a balancing of reciprocating masses. So minimizing the effect of these two factors. Now moving further, so on this figure there are several forces, so one by one we are going to see that forces. So first force FR. So FR is a force required to accelerate the reciprocating part. So in this case, a reciprocating part is a piston, एंड एफ आर इज फोर्स रिक्वायर्ड टू एक्सेलरेट और मूव दिस पिस्टन इज द फोर्स इज कॉल्ड एज एफ आर एंड विच इज गोइंग टू एक्ट इन दिस डिरेक्शन अलॉन्ग द एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन ऑफ द क्रैंक. देन नेक्स्ट फोर्स एफ आई इज अ इनर्शिया फोर्स ड्यू टू रेसिप्रोकेटिंग पावर. सो दिस इज एफ आई एंड दिस इज अ फोर्स ड्यू टू इनर्शिया फोर्स ड्यू टू रेसिप्रोकेटिंग पार्ट्स एंड दिस इज इक्वल एंड अपोजिट टू द एफ आर. देन नेक्स्ट फोर्स इज एफ एन. सो फोर्स ऑन द साइड्स ऑफ सिलेंडर वॉल और नॉर्मल फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन द क्रॉस हेड गाइड. सो नॉर्मल फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन द सिलेंडर इन साइड विच द पिस्टन इज गोइंग टू रेसिप्रोकेट. सो दिस इज एफ एन. देन एफ बी द फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन द क्रैंकशाफ्ट बियरिंग और मेन बियरिंग. सो हियर देर इज अ वन बियरिंग वी कैन से क्रैंकशाफ्ट बियरिंग एंड एफ बी इज द फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन दिस बियरिंग. ओके सो अलॉन्ग विद दिस सो देर आर टू मोर फोर्सेस एफ बी वी एंड एफ बी एच. दीज आर नथिंग बट आफ्टर रिजोल्विंग दिस फोर्स देन द वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट ऑफ दिस फोर्स इज एफ बी वी. मीन्स वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट ऑफ बियरिंग फोर्स इज एफ बी वी एंड हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट ऑफ द बियरिंग फोर्स इज एफ बी एच एंड that is equal to fu. so fu is nothing but unbalanced force. fu is nothing but unbalanced force. okay, moving further. now since fr and fi are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Now one by one we see the forces Fi and Fr are the equal and opposite in direction. Therefore they balance each other. Okay, therefore these two forces balance each other. The horizontal component Fb, the horizontal component of Fb, that is horizontal component of FB, that is FBH, acting along the line of reciprocation is also equal and opposite to FI. So this is equal and opposite to FI. This force FBH is equal to FU, is an unbalanced force or shaking force and required to be properly balanced. So in this case, so we suppose to balance this force, which is unbalanced force. So here these two forces are going to balance each other. So that's why we required over here, so additional balancing of the FBH, or we can say FU. Then moving further, the force on side of the cylinder wall, that is Fn. So force on the side wall of Fn and vertical component of Fb, that is Fbv. So this force, so Fn is moving upward direction and Fbv is moving downward direction, are equal and opposite and thus form shaking couple of magnitude Fn into x. So when we are going to take the moment about O, then the Fn into O, okay, so all remaining forces are going to zero. So Fn into x, so this is the first couple or shaking couple. And second, when we are going to take the moment about P, then FBV into X, FBV into X. So here there is a generation of, as we already discussed, that there is a generation of first unbalanced force. So unbalanced force is here, and the shaking couple or unbalanced couple is generated due to the FBV and FN. So from above we see that effect of reciprocating parts is to produce a shaking force and shaking couple. So here we see because of which force there is a generation of shaking force and shaking couple. Since the shaking force and shaking couple vary in magnitude and direction during engine cycle, therefore they cause very objectionable vibrations. So first, unbalanced force or shaking force, or we say the force generated due to inertia force, okay, and couple generated to FBV and couple generated to FN. So these forces are going to generate the objectionable vibration. So thus the purpose of balancing of reciprocating masses is to eliminate shaking force and shaking couple. Sorry. Thus the purpose of balancing the reciprocating masses is to eliminate the shaking force and shaking couple. Okay. So purpose of balancing of reciprocating masses is to eliminate or minimize the shaking force and shaking couple. In most of the mechanism, we can reduce shaking force and shaking couple by adding approximate balancing mass. So like balancing of rotary masses, here also we are going to add the approximate balancing mass. But it is usually not practical to eliminate them completely. So we are unable to eliminate them completely. In other words, reciprocating masses are only partially balanced. So here we are unable to eliminate the unbalanced force, shaking force, and the shaking couple. So here we are going to minimize the effect of them. That's why here we are able to do only the partial balancing. So last note, the masses rotating with the crankshaft are normally balanced and they do not transmit any unbalanced or shaking force on the body of engine. So here, as the crankshaft is a rotary part and we are able to balance the rotary part completely, so that's why there is no effect of the rotation of crankshaft on the body of engine. But the reciprocating part, in case of reciprocating part, we are able to partial balanced it. Okay, so this is about the introduction of balancing of reciprocating masses. So in further video we are going to discuss about the partial balancing of reciprocating masses.